All right, we have shown you some of the damage in Sutton from earlier today. Very scary scene out there from the tornado, but we are going to head back out there now. We've heard reports that the power is still out. Chris and Colin, I have the latest.
Lauren, any residents in the town of Sutton that work in downtown won't be going to work tomorrow. Saunders Avenue, where this tornado ripped through, has been shut off. And right here, if anyone needs to go to the grocery store tomorrow at Brown's Thrift Store, well, they won't be going because of how the tornado ripped the roof off the wall that was just replaced. Brown's Thrift Store, believe it or not, was preparing for renovations. And now you can see some of these boards are ripped up. And there's still nails sticking out. A lot of danger here. That's why police presence will be barricading off Saunders Avenue. And because of the wind, which has picked up, some of the debris could move. There's bricks on the wall. They want to make sure there's no looters that come to the area. So it's just been a rough night for the residents of Sutton. The police department is on this street. They're set up right now inside the fire hall just around the corner. So the residents of Sutton have a lot of cleaning up to do. But luckily, once again, no injuries were reported. And Lauren, we'll have much more on this tomorrow on News 5 Today. For now, back to you.
Thank you, Colin. I mean, that is just, it's horrible to look at. It's so scary.
It's scary, and you just to think no one was injured from that. Just, you know,
it's incredible
how easy a brick could have hit someone or something. That's just pretty awesome to know.
And as we said, that power is out. The light that you saw, the emergency crews came in and brought in just giant lights to help light up parts of the city. We will again have more on this tomorrow.